Hallo allemaal en welkom bij vandaagse episode van die Rongo Talk. Mijn naam is Leandrello en vandaag kuier ons vanaf die Pelican Bay Hotel hier in 'n koue walvisbaai. Ons bring dan vandaag vir julle die nuus as ook Grampie se visvangverslag, die weer en getuie. En dan vir ons onderhoud, Miss Supranational 2021 Shanique Rabie het onlangs gekuier by die Tualaloka Aid, Support and Kindness, dit is die task organisasie. Hulle voer omtrent so 400 kinders weekliks in Narrewil as ook in Koosepmond. Nou, ons gesels met Toya Lou, die stichter van Task, en dan Miss Supranational Namibia. Dit is Monique Smit. Gaan ook so 'n bietjie meer vir ons vertel van hoe het hulle betrokke geraak. So, bly asseblief ingeskakel. Ons is nou weer terug.
Is there a difference between heaven and hell? That man depends upon where your soul dwells. With the heart of a lion, so I must rebel. Listen up, cause thoughts can get a story to tell. The mama stays strong. Without no love, there's no love at all. Mama stays strong.
En nou is het tyd vir die nuus en ons kuier langs die kaggel hier by die Pelican Bay Hotel in 'n koue walvisbaai. Nou 'n groep visser wat in Wedewees en die Hika Fishing het hulle verskille uitgestryk. Nou volgens Royo van Wyk, 'n stigterslid van die Fisherman Widows Trust en 'n lid van die Hika Fishing, sal die Wedewees nou meer insig hê oor die trust wat in hul naam gestig is. Nou hy sê die Wedewees het hulle eie komitee en trustees gekies en twee van hulle lede sal op die Hika Fishing se direksie dien. Hulle sal deelneem aan algemene jaarvergaderings sowel as direksievergaderings en gaan ook namens die trust aktief betrokke wees by die onderneming se besluitnemingsproses. Nou die nuwe komitee wat gekies is of wat die Wedewees wel sê is dat hulle het gevoel dat hulle eie stem nodig het van slegs Hika Fishing was beheer van sake. Die vorige trustees het nou bedank en die Wedewees het hulle eie verteenwoordigers gekies. Nou die huidige Fisherman's Widows Trust komitee lede is Paul Fisher, wat die voorsitter is, Leonie Won, ondervoorsitter, Lizette Williams, wat is die tesourier is, en dan Vanessa Nes is die sekretaresse. Maar julle kan gerus gaan loer daar op ons webwerf, dis www.irongo.com.na om meer hieroor te lees. En dan volgende Hoërskool Westside, dit is nou in Swakopmund, wat meer as 1200 leerlinge akkommodeer, het 2 maande gelede 'n 16 sitplek bus aangeskaf. Nou die skoolhoof, dit is Vanessa Reder, wat die leisels 310 dae gelede oorgeneem het, het gesê die ouers het 'n insamelingsinisiatief van stapel gestuur om vervoer vir die skool te bekom. Nou die bus het 16 sitplekke en die skool het dit kontant gekoop. Dus het ons geen skuld nie. My grootste wens is dat die skool binne die volgende 5 jaar nog 4 minibusse kan koop. Ons is 'n gekombineerde skool met meer as 1000 leerlinge, het Reder gesê. Verder aan het sy ook gesê die skool het 'n wenslys en die skoolgebou wat in 'n vervalle toestand het ook sorg nodig aangesien die skool reeds as meer as 40 jaar oud is. Nou die kragtoevoer verg aandag, dakke lek en sommige vensters kan nie oopmaak nie. 'N Speelgrond is ook 'n noodsaaklikheid vir die pre-primêre leerlinge wat deur die speel leer. Die sportveld kort dan ook aandag. En dan, en ten laaste, die munisipaliteit van Walvisbaai het onlangs 123 beton asdromme ter waarde van 80.000 Namibiese dollar bekom en op strategiese plekke oral oor die hawe dorp geplaas. Nou die stap is gedoen om rommelstrooiing te bekamp en die asdromme is aangebring na Wêreldskoonmaakdag in September herdenk is. Nou die nuwe asdromme vervang die ou plastiekdromme wat langs die strand neergelee was terwyl die res op verskillende plekke in die dorp aangebring is. Nou volgens Pieter Etzebeth van die departement van afvalbestuur by die munisipaliteit het vandale ongelukkig reeds van die nuwe asblikke vernietig. Een van die vullishouers wat ons in Narwo geplaas het, is die volgende dag reeds beskadig. Hy het gevra dat die mense asseblief 'n beroep gedoen op die inwoners om nie die nuwe asdromme te vandaliseer nie. Maar soos ek reeds gesê het, kan julle gaan loer op ons webwerf, dis www.irongo.com.na, dis www.irongo.com.na om al hierdie lekker stories te lees en soveel meer wat hier in die Irongo streek aangaan. En dan kan jy ook vandag se Republikein koop waar jy die nuutste Irongo nuus kan lees. Bly asseblief ingeskakel.
I'm Shanique Robert, Miss Sikkim National 2021, and I had an incredible day with Monique Smith, Miss Sikkim National Namibia, and the task team. We handed out amazing food to two different locations in the Belfast Bay community. And thanks to Monique Smith and the task team, they make food three times a week to give to people in need, especially in the Belfast area with all the burnt down houses recently. So from my side, I would like to share my gratitude and an honor to have served today and to have worked just a couple of hours with these amazing people. And I wish to see more Namibians be part of projects like this, uplifting our community and helping where there's need. Thank you so much to the amazing people doing their utmost best to help around. And thank you once again to Task and Monique Smith, Miss Supranational Namibia. I see you soon.
I had a friend that was doing yoga classes with me, Iveline, and she came up with the idea that we should start making soup for the children in the township, because we could see how so many people had lost their jobs, people were unemployed overnight. So we started making food at home, and I got a couple of friends together and we cooked food. And then we took it out in the pots on the back of my landy out into the township and started feeding. And then about 2 months later, there was a massive fire in Twalaluka that destroyed all those shacks, and quite a few thousand people lost their homes. And then we stepped in immediately and then started getting more people to come in and asking for donations so that we could feed on a daily basis. Which we did. We then went out every day and fed the kids. It was from Monday to Friday. The church stepped in and helped us as well, the Catholic Church. And the Round Table stepped in and helped us. And then after the fire and once everyone got settled into their tents, then we decided to continue. Because we got to know the children, and we've been doing it ever since for 18 months, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. You know, I must say, I've just found being part of this project, or starting this project, has made me feel like a better person, because we're giving. You know, we need to give. You can't have everything for yourself and can't keep everything for yourself. Unfortunately, there's such a big bridge or a gap in this country between the rich and the poor. And I feel that if you have something, you can give a little bit, even if it's a bag of macaroni or a little bit of money towards this project, or fill up a gas bottle for us, or give us a combo from fruit and veg, or donate money towards the project. It really isn't difficult. It's not an expensive project to run. For what we're doing, we can run it fairly economically. So if people could just realize that these are children that are hungry and that need food, and the only way that they're going to get further in life is to have a proper nutritious diet. I wish we could do this every day, but we're doing it three times a week, so it's a start. But maybe we'll get to the point where we could possibly do this every day. Today we probably fed about 400. You guys were out there. It varies, but minimum 300 children to 400, sometimes even 500.
So what are some of the daily needs? What do you need in terms of food to actually make the soup?
So to make the soup, we make it with macaroni. That's our sort of basic thing, and potatoes, because the potatoes are quite filling. And we don't peel the potatoes, we just chop them with the skin on, because that's very nutritious. and we add butternut and carrots and garlic and onions. And what else? Then we add peas. We have dried peas or split peas. So whatever we can get. We don't bake the puff because it's really difficult to stir, and you've got to keep stirring. It uses a lot of gas and needed a lot of power for that. So it's easier for us to use macaroni. We were also donated a lot of rice recently from Donna Collins and Swapop, you know, the lady that works with the animals. She gave us lots of rice. So we do rice dishes as well. And then we add meat. Whenever we can, we do soup bones, which, you know, just gives a nice flavor to the food. And then we add lots of soya beans as well. And then we have soup mixes. You know, we add whatever we can. Cabbage, lots of cabbage. Lots of carrots. Freezer's normally full of veggies that we chop up beforehand.
Supranational and Miss Supranational Namibia joint task. Please tell us about the experience.
You know, I feel so blessed that they came here today. It was one of the best days ever that we've had at task. They were so keen and so amped to be here. And I want to thank Monique for that, and obviously Miss Supranational 2021. And all the other girls that joined, and you guys. I mean, this is amazing. We also had Miss Namibia a while back. You remember, she was here with us too. It would be great if she could come back again. But yeah, that helps boost our project.
Monique, you are Miss Supranational Namibia, and you're from Walvis Bay. How does it feel to be back again in Walvis Bay?
It feels awesome. It's always so nice coming home. And home is better than anything else for me. So I'm so excited and I'm so grateful to be here. I'm so proud that I could be a representative for Walvis Bay. And I hope that with this, a lot of the other women and young ladies will participate and grow from this as well.
Awesome. Now, even before you were crowned Miss Supranational and first runner-up, you were involved with TASC.
Yes.
Where did the relationship come about? How did you guys meet?
I actually came across Toya through social media, actually. So from there on, I reached out to her, asked if she needs any help. And so, like I mentioned before, that we need so much help from the community with donating and everything. So from there on, just bringing awareness to the group, helping expose them and all of that. So, yes.
Now, you also had Miss Supranational, Shanique Rabi, here with us today. How did the idea come about to bring them along?
Well, it started when the entire Miss Supranational team came for the victory tour in Namibia after Shanique has won. And I thought, okay, what a brilliant idea would be to bring them here as well and for them to see what TASC does specifically, to bring exposure and to make them aware of the everyday lives and the weekly feedings of TASC and the team to the community.
Awesome.
Well, first of all, I want to try and fulfill my duties here in Namibia at first. And obviously I have big shoes to fill, so I will do my best to have them filled. So I have been receiving a lot of love and support from my community, especially Walvis Bay and all. And I hope to lead by example and show young women, especially women of color, that you can do it. You can live larger than life. You can actually use this platform to amplify your voice and make a change. So to all the young women out there, you have what it takes.
Thank you.
And now it's time for Grumpy's fishing report. Now it says that the cob were biting readily. Now young Rudy Swartz and his dad went fishing at the Winston Wreck, targeting sharks with snook heads as bait. It wasn't long before the 13-year-old rod started bending. The fight was on and soon the fish was in the shore break. Now everything went according to plan, except that it wasn't a shark but a massive cob. Superfish indeed, weighing an amazing 19.3 kilograms. Not only is this a fish of a lifetime, but father and son decided to release the fish after a quick photo. The fish was handled with wet hands and not taken onto dry sand. Father and son are both experienced anglers. I have so much respect for anglers that release trophy fish. Well done. Now, Carly Langenveld went fishing close to Cape Cross at Canopy and he got a massive surprise. His rod was almost snatched out of his hands by a big fish. Now, after a few anxious moments, Carly succeeded in landing his big and very nice steenbra. Closer to Antis, areas like Trappies and Popeye also produced catches. Now, Uwe Hansen took his son, Calum, that's 5 years old, fishing. Dad baited his hook and it wasn't long before a fish hit his bait. The tussle was on and in the end, Calum succeeded in landing a decent cob. I'm sure that this kid is hooked now. Salome Franken also landed a massive steenbra. Superfish indeed, Salome. Closer to Swakopmund, with Drake Tanna being the venue, a cob of 17 kilograms was caught. With the catches that were reported this weekend, I can clearly see that the cob are back with a vengeance, says Grumpy. So get your tackle gear ready and go target some of these delicious tasting fish. The ski boat anglers are also excited as the snook are finally back and biting readily, although still quite far out. However, this could change quickly. The size is also quite impressive. Make sure you stock up on these inexpensive fish as they are most welcome on a family braai. Try them with some garlic butter and apricot jam. Bon appetit. Tight lines. Until next time, says Grumpy. This week on Irongo Talk, we travel to Conception Water. Now, Conception Bay was initially used as a harbour. Now, during 1912 and 1913, a light railway from Conception Bay to Conception Water was constructed. A police station, doubling as a customs office, was erected at Conception Water, where boreholes were also sunk for fresh water abundant in the area. Today, this police office slash customs office now serves as a tiny museum. From Conception Water, an 80-kilometer water pipeline was constructed to supply the three mining settlements with water. Join us again next time, right here on Irongo Talk.
Voor Walvispaai is de maximum temperatuur 21 graden Celsius met een minimum van 14 graden Celsius en een maximum van 20 graden Celsius voor morgen. Die wind is verwacht om een noordwestelijke richting te waai ten 11 km per uur. Die zon het vandaag 27 minuten voor 7 opgekomen en zal 5 minuten oor 7 zak. Voor Swakopmund is de maximum temperatuur 20 graden Celsius met een minimum van 14 graden Celsius en een maximum van 20 graden Celsius voor morgen. Die wind is verwacht om in die noordwestelike richting te waai teen 9 km per uur. Die son het vanoggend 27 minute voor 7 opgekom en sal 5 minute oor 7 sak. Vir Rentiesbaai is die maximum temperatuur 20 grade Celsius met 'n minimum temperatuur van 14 grade Celsius en 'n maximum temperatuur van 20 grade Celsius vir môre. Die wind is verwacht om in een west-noordwestelijke richting te waai, geen 11 km per uur. Die zon het volgens 26 minuten voor 7 opgekomen en zal 5 minuten voor 7 zak. Voor Arendus verwacht ons een maximum temperatuur van 33 graden Celsius met een minimum temperatuur van 12 graden Celsius en een maximum temperatuur van 31 graden Celsius voor morgen. Die wind is verwacht om in een west-noordwestelijke richting te waai en 11 km per uur. Die zon het vanochtend 29 minuten voor 7 opgekomen en zal 3 minuten voor 7 zak. Voor Oosakos is die maximum temperatuur van 39 graden Celsius met een minimum temperatuur van 14 graden Celsius en een maximum temperatuur van 38 graden Celsius voor morgen. Die wind is verwacht om in een zuidoostrichting te waai teen 13 km per uur. Die zon het vanochtend 31 minuten voor 7 opgekomen en zal later vandaag 7 uur zak. Voor Karibab is een maximum temperatuur van 39 graden Celsius met een minimum temperatuur van 14 graden Celsius en een maximum temperatuur van 38 graden Celsius voor morgen. Die wind is verwacht om in de oostrichting te waai teen 11 km per uur. Die zon het vanochtend 32 minuten voor 7 opgekomen en zal later vandaag 1 minuut voor 7 zak. Voor Omaruru verwacht ons een maximum temperatuur van 39 graden Celsius met een minimum temperatuur van 15 graden Celsius en een maximum temperatuur van 39 graden Celsius voor morgen. Die wind is verwacht om in die oostrichting te waai teen 13 km per uur. Die zon het vanochtend 32 minuten voor 7 opgekomen en zal later vandaag 2 minuten voor 7 zak.
En dit bring ons ongelukkig aan die einde van vandagse episode van Irongo Talk, maar jylle kan gerus gaan loer op ons webwerf, dis www.irongo.com.na, dis www.irongo.com.na, om te lees oor wat alles hier in die Irongo streken aangaan. Jylle kan ons ook volg op Facebook, Twitter en op Instagram, en jylle kan gerus ons TV-kanaal gaan besoek by oneup2.com. Dan ook kan jylle vir ons gaan kontak op Telegram, op WhatsApp by 0811-7040, dis 0811-7040. Onthou asseblief om veilig te wees, waar ook al jy is, en dan sien jylle dan weer môre. Geniet dit. Bye bye!